from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. The latest tonight on a plane headed to Maine that went down in central Massachusetts. Aviation officials say the small plane crashed near the airport in the town of Orange last night, killing both people on board. The single-engine Cessna originally took off from Maryland and had stopped in Massachusetts to refuel at the Orange Municipal Airport when it went down near a wooded area about a mile north of the airport. The FAA says the plane is registered to 61-year-old Jack Johnson from Maryland. His passenger was 52-year-old Joseph Jasso Jr. of San Antonio, Texas. Federal officials are trying to figure out the pilot's flight plan.
The pilot have to be considered a hero to take a plane down and not have it land on any houses, because there's quite a few houses in this area, and for them to manage to get it away, I guess, from what I understand, there was reports of him having engine problems a couple miles away. So for him to manage to veer it away from the houses, he's got to be commended for that.
Investigators have been on the scene today trying to pinpoint exactly what caused the plane to crash. The boyfriend of a missing Scarborough woman has been arrested by Maine drug agents charged with unlawful trafficking in cocaine base. Investigators say they arrested 20-year-old Akeem Cruz while looking into a complaint of suspected drug trafficking from a room at a South Portland motel. Officers say they found Cruz with crack cocaine with a street value of $1,300. He's being held at the Cumberland County Jail tonight without bail. Cruz's girlfriend, 22-year-old Megan Waterman, was last seen in early June at a hotel room in New York. Police believe she advertises as an escort on Craigslist and says she often travels to New York with Cruz, who is from Brooklyn. He has not facing any charges in Waterman's disappearance. The controversial measure to allow legal non-U.S. citizens the right to vote in Portland will be decided this November. This morning, the city's clerk's office said the League of Young Voters has turned in the 5,600 signatures needed to put the question on the November ballot. The proposed charter amendment would allow immigrants who are not U.S. citizens to vote in municipal elections if they are residents of Portland. The law would not apply to state or federal elections. Supporters of the proposal say it is only fair to grant voting rights to residents who pay taxes, have children enrolled in public schools, and receive city services, even if they are not citizens. The state is about to wage war on Scarborough Marsh. By early September, specially trained crews will begin removing a non-native, highly invasive plant called Phragmites. Even though it looks like a naturally growing grass, experts say the plant is choking the marsh, already spreading across 100 of the marsh's 3,200 acres. The organization Friends of Scarborough Marsh has been documenting its spread for more than a decade. Biologists from Inland Fisheries and Wildlife will oversee the project. They say they will use specially formulated herbicide that will kill the plant but will not harm wildlife. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. Tracy Sable, stay with us for latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.